This tutorial will look at the Labels tool in Gmail. Labels are similar to folders in that both can be used to organize email. Where they differ is that with labels, an email can have more than one label applied to it, as well as stay in the inbox for as long as you deem necessary. Gmail displays labels over on the left-hand side of the interface. Some of these labels are system labels. They are provided by Google, like Inbox, Starred, and Sent Mail. Other labels are provided by you, the user, which are listed down below. Some of these labels may have come over through the email migration, but you can edit them, and you can add new ones, and you can remove other ones as you see fit. If we look in the inbox here, you can see that I have some emails that have no labels, some that have one label, and others here that have more than one label. An email can have as many labels as you want. For example, let's go into this email that I've created for a test, and I want to apply some labels to it. So in the email, I'm going to come up here and I'm going to click on the Labels button. And here's my labels list. And I can check off as many labels as I think apply to this email. So let's give this email blogs, gaff, and IT. And when I click Apply, you'll now notice at the top I have these three labels applied to this email. Also notice that there's also an inbox label. The inbox, just like anything else, is also a label. If I come over here to my labels, and let's go down to the IT label, you'll notice, oh, look, here's that email that I provide a label. So it's located in this IT label. If I go to GAF, you'll notice it's also in this label. So the email is not duplicated, but it's merely accessible in multiple locations that I deemed that apply to this email. You can modify some of the labels right from the left-hand side interface. If you hold your cursor over a label and click the triangle to the right of it, you get a drop-down menu with some options for label management, like label color, how the label is displayed in the list over here on the left, how the label is displayed in the drop-down list when we were in the email. You can remove a label right from here, add a sublabel, and actually access the full editor for managing your labels from this menu. You can also access labels by going up to the gear settings on the right-hand side and clicking Settings. In Settings, click on the Labels tab at the top. And now here are all the labels that will be in your Gmail account. At the top are system labels provided by Gmail. And farther down the list are your custom labels that you've created. Next to each label are some of the settings that you can edit. Notice that the items that are bolded are the settings that are currently active. So for example, starred is set to show. It's visible on the left-hand side here. Important is set to hide. It is not visible over here on the left-hand side. It is, however, available down here at the bottom under more. So there's important. Drafts and spam are set to show if unread. So if there's nothing in these labels that needs your attention, they will not be displayed in the label lists. So for example, spam is not visible. There's nothing in spam that needs my attention. Drafts, however, is visible because there is something in that label that needs my attention. Going down to my labels, you'll notice there are some additional options, including show in the label list on the left, showing the message list within an email. You can also remove the labels, and you can edit the labels. Editing the label allows you to rename labels, as well as nest a label or put it under another one. Checking it off, you select the label you'd like to nest it under. So for example, if you look at IT here, I have several labels that I've already nested underneath it. So you can create new labels from the Create New Label button here at the top. And labels are automatically displayed in alphabetical order. So, labels are a great way to organize your email. But remember that unlike folders, an email can have more than one label. You can tell Gmail if you like certain labels to be visible all the time, none of the time, or some of the time. You can put labels within labels, what they call nesting, as you see fit. You can also color code your labels so that they stand out in your inbox, like so. And you can remove labels you don't need. This concludes this tutorial.